Good morning and welcome this morning to our Recognition Sunday as we congratulate all of our graduates. And thank you so much, Jeanette Adams, for all the love that you have put into preparing to celebrate our graduates and just the great love and joy that you bring to all of us. So thank you for that. And so this morning we applaud the accomplishments of our young people, especially in light of the great challenges that they have faced in their academic and social and personal lives over these past few months. And we are also especially grateful to them for their leadership in these past few weeks and taking the lead and organizing, showing up and speaking out against matters of racial injustices, which have run for way too long and run way too deep in our nation and in our communities. So thank you to all of our young people that have really been leading us and showing us the way forward in this and doing all of this with the many different gifts that they have, their God-given gifts through their music, their art, their writing, their showing up. So thank you. And this year, as Jeanette has been preparing for our high school graduates, it is my understanding that usually at Recognition Sunday is when we're able to bring them up. But since we are not able to do that this year, we are actually will be going to them. So we are planning a special celebratory procession for this week to be able to bring them their graduation gifts. So if you would be interested in joining that, please reach out to Jeanette and we can fill you in on our further details on doing that. But we just, look forward to being able to celebrate our graduates as best we can. And so for all of our young people, as you all continue to grow into the beautiful people that God has called you to be and use your God-given gifts, we also give you the charge to continue in this holy work, this very challenging work of leading us in how we can heal this world. And so thank you to our young people, and we charge you to continue your work in this healing. And along with that, we thank all of those who are serving as our worship leaders this morning, all of our young people, and Father Jim, who will be preaching a good word for us. Thank you to Jaslyn and to George and Ben and Tyanne for our music this morning, and to Aaliyah and Nia and Shiloh, Carter, Sophia, Charlotte, Kay, and Chris. Thank you all so much for pulling this all together and leading us in our worship. And later in the service, we will be honoring our acolytes and our graduating senior acolytes and our acolyte of the year. And many thanks to George and Tamba and Chris, who have prepared a special postlude honoring all of our graduates. So I'm grateful to all of you for preparing that special celebratory postlude for us. And thank you all again for being here for this Recognition Sunday. And let us prepare ourselves and heart and mind to be present to the holy in our midst.
We give you thanks, O God, we give you thanks, calling upon your name and declaring all your wonderful deeds. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, to set forth God's praise, to hear God's holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things that are necessary for our life and our salvation, and so that we may prepare ourselves in heart and mind to worship God, let us sit in silence and with penitent and obedient hearts confess our sins, that we may obtain forgiveness by God's infinite goodness and mercy.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Come and seek the ways of wisdom, she who danced when earth was new. Follow closely what she teaches, for her words are right and true. Wisdom clears the path to justice, showing us what love must do. Listen to the voice of wisdom, crying in the marketplace. Hear the word made flesh among us, full of glory, truth, and grace. When the word takes root and ripens, peace and righteousness embrace. Sister Wisdom, come assist us, nurture all who seek rebirth. Spirit guide and close companion, bring to light our sacred worth. Free us to become your people, holy friends of God and earth.
I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication.
Because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I called upon him.
How shall I repay the Lord
for all the good things he has done for me?
I will lift up the cup of salvation
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people.
Righteous in the sight of the Lord
is the death of his servants.
O Lord, I am your servant.
I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds.
I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people,
in the court of the Lord's house,
in the midst of you, O Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from Romans, chapter 5-8. A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ.
through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our offerings, suffering, knowing that suffering produces endurance, endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For a while, we are still weak at the time Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person. So perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we still were sinners, Jesus Christ died for us. The word of God.
Thanks be to God.
I believe that New Year's Eve be the perfect time for the great surrender, but they don't remember. Anger wants a voice, voices want to sing, singers harmonize till they can't hear anything. I thought that I was free from all that questioning, but every time a problem ends, another one begins. And the stone walls of the Harmony Hall bear witness. Anybody with a worried mind could never forgive the sight of wicked snakes inside a place you thought was dignified. I don't want to live like this, but I don't want to die. Like the young pretenders. Beneath these velvet gloves I hide the shameful crooked hands of a moneylender, 'cause I still remember. Anger wants a voice, voices want to sing, singers harmonize till they can't hear anything. I thought that I was free from all that questioning. Every time a problem ends, another one begins. And the stone walls of the Harmony Hall bear witness. Anybody with a worried mind could never forgive the sight of wicked snakes inside a place you thought was dignified. I don't want to live like this, but I don't want to die. Die. And the stone walls of the Harmony Hall bear witness. Anybody with a worried mind can never forgive the sight of wicked snakes inside a place you thought was dignified. I don't want to live like this, but I don't want to die. I don't want to live like this, but I don't want to die. Thank you.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without shepherds. Then he told to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are some names of those 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, Philip, and Bartholomew, Thomas, and Matthew, the tax collectors, James, son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas the Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions: go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You receive without payment, you give without payment. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, this was kind of the recognition day for the first 12 apostles, the first 12 disciples, called by name, sent out. In Matthew's gospel, whatever Jesus does with the disciples, he does with us, because we are the descendants of the disciples. We are the new disciples of Jesus Christ in this generation. And I hope and pray that our new graduates at whatever level will recognize that whatever it is that you're going on to do, more education, higher education, work, service in the mill, whatever it happens to be, that the charge that Jesus gives the 12 today, he gives to you, just as he's given to us older folks earlier in our lives. To do what? To proclaim the good news that the kingdom of God is near, to heal what's wrong in the world, and to exercise, which means to cast out evil. That's the mission that we all have. Now, this phrase, "preach the kingdom of God is near," that's church talk. What does that mean? I can tell you what I think it means. To tell people by what we do and what we say to them that the kingdom of God is here and near means to tell them, you know what? This is God's world. I don't care whose world you think it is. I don't care if you think it belongs to the rich and powerful. I don't think if you think it belongs to the crazy folk. I don't think whether you think it belongs to, you know, evil spirits. This is God's world, and God is here. God is in this cosmos and in this community and in this world in which we live. God's the one who is in charge, no matter how else it seems. That's the deal. We don't have to go seek God. We don't have to go to a mountaintop. We don't have to make a pilgrimage to the South Pole. God is here, and he's the one who's running the joint. And so our mission is to live as if that were true, because it is true. To live as if God were in charge. And that boils down to some very simple but not always easy things. And the simple part is, we're taught to take the God of the cosmos, the God of Israel that we couldn't even say his name. High priest could say it once a year. The God of the universe, the God who created everything, the God that's so far beyond our abilities to understand, we can't even conceive that, and to treat that God as if that God was a loving parent, a loving father, or a loving mother, and expect that that God will treat us that way in return. That's the good news. That's the good news. Forces of evil are not in charge, no matter how it may seem. This is God's world and God's in charge. And then to bring forth words of healing and the expulsion of evil. If this pandemic has taught us nothing, it should have taught us that evil is like a virus. And it's infectious. And it's mostly infectious by what comes out of our mouths. That's why we're wearing masks. Okay, we're not playing Halloween here. But to put a limit on what comes out of our mouth and how far it can go. Because even though we may not want it to be, there's stuff that will hurt us and hurt other people if we breathe it out into the air. Our spoken words are like that. And there is the virus of evil and racism, of sickness, of social injustice, of economic injustice. Those are viruses, and by the way, just like a virus, every time we start to get these evil viruses under control, every time we spiritually develop an antibody and a vaccine, and we get one of them, it just mutates. It just changes its form and comes back in spades. That's what it does. It's done it for all eternity. It's done it since the beginning of humanity. It does it now. Every time we think we get something good, and we do, right? Every time we cure something, it comes back in another more virulent strain. And so we have to go to the spiritual equivalent of just pure research, and that's prayer. That's prayer and worship and begging God to give us the strength and the ability, first of all, as we are sent out to teach and preach the kingdom, to pray for the healing within ourselves, so that those things that are not so terrific, that are even evil within ourselves, that God will give us the antibodies to combat those things so we don't infect others with them. And in fact, God will give us the vaccine so that we can bring that forth. A way of thinking about the disciples being sent out is, you know, they're God's CDC. All right. You know, they're Christ's divine community sent out into the world. What? To bring the antibodies to sin and evil and hatred to anyone who'll take it, to anyone who'll listen to it. And by the way, you'll note in the passage in Matthew that they're told, don't waste a lot of time trying to convince people who aren't interested in listening to you or engaging in conversation with you. Say to them, you know, peace be with you. And if they say, hey, peace be, if they want to engage with you, they want to really enter into a dialogue, spend as much time with them as you can. And if they don't become enraged, don't become hateful, but shake the dust off your feet, which means just leave them alone, because, you know, you can't preach to a brick wall. And so, what God is asking us to do in these most troubled times is to develop within our communities, within our church, within St. Mark's, within our very selves, by the power of prayer and God's transforming grace, the antibodies for hatred and injustice and illness, okay? For the demons of racism, for the demons of hatred, for the demons of injustice that exists all around us and frankly within us. And then to go out and spread that word, spread the antibodies, that when good things come out of our mouths, when holy things come out of our mouths. And by the way, good things, that's when we look at somebody who's done a good job and say, good job. By the way, we shouldn't look at somebody who hasn't done a good job and say, good job, because that's just BS, and in this case, BS doesn't stand for baptism in the Spirit. Goodness also comes out of our mouth by confronting evil. Years ago in this town, some of you are old enough to remember, a young man named Pennell was killed in a shooting by the police. And there were demonstrations. And I was with a fellow clergy person on Cedar Lane, walking into a shop as the demonstration went by. And the shopkeeper, well, that shopkeeper started saying, and forgive me, children, I'm sorry you have to hear this, but he started saying, nigger this and nigger that and nigger the other thing. And my colleague turned to him and said, I have shopped in this place virtually every week as long as I've lived in this town. You shut up. If I ever hear that word come out of your mouth again, not only will I never come in here again, but I will preach from the pulpit that this is a sinful place and nobody should give you a dime. And that fool replied, I have a right to say whatever I want. She said, yeah, and so do I. Shut up. It's evil. I don't want to hear that infectious crap coming out of your mouth. And that's really what it was, infectious. That was a word of goodness. That was a word of power. That was confronting evil face to face. We need to have that kind of courage. We need to take ourselves in hand and open ourselves to God's grace. This commission is ours. Notice, by the way, when you look at the 12 that Jesus picked, if Jesus was a bishop in the Episcopal Church, and this is the guys he was picking for ordination, they'd fire him as a bishop. Look at who he picked. Peter, who denied him 3 times. Judas, who sold him out and then was a suicide. He picked one guy who was a zealot, which means he was fighting, sometimes secretly and sometimes violently they were, to overthrow the Roman occupation. And Matthew, who was a tax collector, which meant he was a collaborator with the Romans. And a whole bunch of guys we don't actually know much about. They should have named the first 12 the Motley Crew. And yet those were the ones he picked because he saw in them, well, what Christ sees in you and me, what Christ sees in you young ones, you graduates who are now moving on to the next stage of your lives. He sees something special. He sees that you have an openness within you to God's love and transforming power. He sees that you have within you the willingness and the ability to infect this world with truth and love and to restrain powers of darkness and the powers of evil, often just by what comes out of your mouth. So let's pray today for those of you who are moving up and moving on. Let's pray for ourselves that we have the grace to move up and to move on and to be a people that hears that the kingdom of God is here now and knows that what that means is no matter what it looks like, this is God's world and God's in charge of it. And we are God's people. And therefore we are to live as if God were in charge, because that's the truth, because God is. And that is to speak the words of truth in love and to resist evil at every turn, starting with the evil that's within each of us, but moving out into the larger community. So I invite you to a moment of prayer and reflection. Author of the world's joy, bearer of the world's pain. In the midst of all our distress, let unconquerable gladness dwell. For you are the end and the beginning. You follow us and you go before. You are the journey and you are the journey's end. Amen. Let God's people say amen.
Amen. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. Deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Keep, O Lord, your household, the church, and your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion. For the sake of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and regents with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Oh God, you made us in your own image and redeem us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred with which infected our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purpose on earth, that in your God's good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
O God, you have made one blood all the peoples of the earth, and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 Let us offer great prayers for all our sisters and brothers in the church and in the world who need mercy. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For this holy gathering and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and fear of God, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We give thanks for the lives and ministries of all those celebrating birthdays and anniversaries this week, remembering especially Nicholas, Marcia, Joseph, Anne, Kenneth, Elizabeth, Kevin, and Ted and Carrie. Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for our presiding Bishop Michael and our Bishop Carly and our priests Joan and Jim. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the light of justice among all peoples, we pray that the evil shadow of racism that so infects our country will be lifted from the eyes of all who hate. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For this parish community of St. Mark's, that we may grow in holiness, for ourselves, our families, and for those we love. For the leaders of nations and for all who seek peace, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those in danger and need, the sick and the suffering, the hungry, homeless, and oppressed, especially on those on St. Mark's prayer chain, and those others for whom we now pray. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who have fallen asleep in Christ, and for all the departed, especially Kevin, Mindy, Inez, and those whom we now name. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Loving and ever-present God, robed in the brightness of spring, you so love the world that you called light into being. We pray our lives may be so illumined by your love that we may honor and comfort, support, and recognize all those upon whose daily work our common livelihood depends. We pray for teachers, transit workers and truckers, nurses and nannies, those who prepare, pack, and provide the food we enjoy, custodians and clergy, farmers and physicians, virologists and vaccine volunteers, first responders and the last responders who lay our loved ones to rest, leaders at every level, and all those whom you know better than we can name. Bless those whose daily struggles have been magnified by this crisis, the homeless and the unemployed, those with disabilities confined to communal living, those who suffer domestic abuse, and all who wrestle personal demons. Enlighten our entitled minds that we may see the divine dignity and God's light in every human you have loved into being, and in all the works of their hands. All this we ask in the name of Jesus, a worker on earth, advocate in heaven.
Amen.
God of every blessing, hear the prayers we offer you this day and plant your people like trees in the garden of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us, to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout the ages. Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church, and in Christ Jesus forever and ever.
Amen.
God has smiled on me. He has set me free. God has smiled on me. He's been good to me. He is the source of all my joy. He fills me with his love. The grace that I employ, he sends down from above. God has smiled on me. He has set me free. God has smiled on me. He's been good to me. A light unto my path is he, my strength when I would fall. He guides each day for me. God is my all in all. God has smiled on me. He has set me free. God has smiled on me. He's been good to me. He's been good to me.
God of all power and love, we give thanks for your unfailing presence and the hope you provide in times of uncertainty and loss. Send your Holy Spirit to enkindle us in holy fire. Revive us to live as Christ's body in the world, a people who pray, worship, learn, break bread, share life, heal neighbors, bear good news, seek justice, rest, and grow in the Spirit. Wherever and however we gather, unite us in common prayer and send us in the common mission, that we and the whole creation might be restored and renewed throughout Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
At this time, we would like to recognize our graduating senior acolytes and acolyte of the year, and I turn this over to Miriam.
Good morning, everybody. St. Mark's is blessed with a very dedicated group of acolytes. They go about their tasks, assisting in worship by lighting and extinguishing candles, carrying the crucifix and gospel book in the procession, receiving the gifts, and assisting at the altar. They do these tasks each Sunday and go above and beyond for special services such as Christmas Eve, Easter, and other occasions. There are 12 acolytes. The senior acolytes are Aaliyah Guzman, Alex Leckie, Howard Houghton, Joshua Houghton, Chidera Asandu, and Emmanuel Asandu. Junior acolytes, some of whom will be moving up to senior acolytes as they enter high school, are Jaden Head, Carter Folks, Grace Davis, Ava Tomlinson, Jaslyn Mitchell, and Caitlin Zenz. Charles Houghton has been a trainee. I was the acolyte director for only 9 Sundays before our pause from worshiping in the church. Liz Davis has agreed to pitch in with the Acolyte Guild, which is really great news. I'd like to acknowledge and recognize Alex Leckie and Howard Houghton, all of the acolytes, but particularly these two fine young men. They really helped me. They were very confident about what they were doing. They really knew what the acolytes bring to the church. And they certainly helped me, and I'd like to acknowledge them particularly and all of the acolytes and wish them luck as they go off to college. The Acolyte of the Year is our way of recognizing and acknowledging outstanding service and ministry. The 2019 Acolyte of the Year was Howard Houghton. And you may have noticed that the silver cross that he wore, which is on your screen right now. Today, this cross will be passed on to another acolyte for outstanding service. Selecting the Acolyte of the Year is not an easy task because they all have made a commitment of time and talent to God's service, which is greatly appreciated by all of us. The Acolyte of the Year is a joint decision by Reverend Joan and myself. Highlights of the criteria include serving as an acolyte for a minimum of 2 years, reliability, proficiency in performing the roles and responsibilities of an acolyte, performing actions carefully and with reverence and punctuality, and mentoring other acolytes. The Acolyte of the Year will wear the special silver cross that you see for the year, and their name is engraved on the Acolyte plaque that's in Carroll Hall. The Acolyte of the Year for 2020 is Joshua Houghton. Congratulations and thank you, Joshua.
And I just want to add to that before we continue that congratulations, Joshua, and all of our best wishes and best prayers to Howard and to Alex as they continue on in their future endeavors and as they go forward. And I just want to say a special thank you to Jackie McLeod and Marcia Mackey, who led this ministry so steadfastly and surely with great encouragement and support for all of our young people. To Jackie and to Marcia for serving as the leaders for our Acolyte ministry over these past 3 years. And Jackie, as she is preparing and moving forward in her process towards ordination to the diaconate, has had to step back from a few things. And so I am grateful to Miriam Lockhart for stepping in and taking the baton from Jackie, and just very grateful to you all, and grateful to Liz Davis, who is assisting Miriam at this time. And again, just for the steadfast leadership and encouragement and support in this formation of our youth, I know I am just ever grateful for. So thank you, especially Jackie and Marcia, and to you, Miriam and Liz. Thank you all so very, very much. And most especially to our young people and young adults who serve and assist as such critical worship leaders in our worship. So thank you all so very, very much.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift up the radiance of her countenance. May she smile upon you and be gracious to you, and may she give you peace. And may the blessing of Almighty God, mother, lover, sister, and friend be with us all and abide with us forevermore. Amen.
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 Amen.